be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Is going to be a what's in my riding bag challenge. And today's video is also our first video. Yay! So I am going to be telling you guys what is in my riding bag, which is basically just what I take to my lesson whenever I go to the barn. So the first thing that I take is all the way down here. So I don't really take these in my riding bag. I'll just put them to the side in the car. So I'll take my sandals just because boots, I think most people can agree, aren't the most comfortable. So once I'm done with my riding lesson, I'll just change into these because a lot of times what will happen is if I don't take these, my feet will kind of start to hurt and get squeezed by the boots. So I just take my, this kind of my home sandals, my walking around sandals to in the car, just so that way my feet aren't hurting after my lesson. So the next couple of things has to do with food. So everything that I'm taking, you can probably just see a little bit that I just pulled up there, but everything that I'm taking is horse edible. So if a horse does accidentally eat it, it's okay. Because it's apple and banana. So apples, most people know that horses love apples. They do. They really do love apples. So I got this apple right here. I also have a banana. Sometimes I'll take either one. Oh, let me take an apple. Oh, let me take a banana. Or I'll take both. And then I will also take some water because in the desert, it's always good to stay hydrated, especially when you are doing an activity such as horse riding or playing any sport really. I'll also take some type of other drink. I'll take like a smoothie or like coconut water just so that I keep my energy up while I'm riding, because what will happen is after I ride, I get really tired, and then the rest of the day, I'm mainly just like exhausted when I could be like drinking a smoothie and just having some nice energy, and I'm not too exhausted after riding. I'll take a smoothie, either an apple or a banana or both, or maybe two bananas, one for me, one for my mom or my dad, or two apples or both. If I want, I'm like, okay, maybe I'll have an apple and banana. Now that it's getting into the winter months, I am starting to take a jacket. So most people don't think it's cold in the desert, but it is cold in the desert. Just like it's really hot in the summer, it is really cold in the desert. Not too cold, but pretty cold. So I do take my lessons early in the morning, so that's why I would take a jacket. Maybe if it was in the middle of the day, I wouldn't need a jacket. But now I'm starting to take my jacket just in case it's cold. And since it's early in the morning, it's definitely going to be a little bit colder. And I got my jacket here. Put that to the side as well. And then this is more of a summer thing. I have a sunshade. I'll also take a hat as well, just like a regular hat. But right now, since it is still fall and it is still sunny, I'll put this on before I go riding. And what this does, it has like an SPF of, I think, like 50. So it's kind of like a sunscreen. I guess you could say a sunscreen shirt. I don't know, a sun shirt. That's what we call it. And you can see from my last riding lesson, there's tons of horse hair. The horses are starting to get their winter coat, so they're shedding out their summer coat and starting to get their winter coat. Yeah, that's how you can tell when winter and fall is coming, and spring too, and summer. Summer, their winter coat is start shedding off, and fall, their summer coat starts shedding off. So I just have some horse hair. Oh, it's falling all over my desk. I have it all over this. I think I gotta wash this. Yeah, I think I definitely gotta wash this because there is like horse hair all over my desk now. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put that to the side to wash. Okay, so the next thing is also kind of a summer thing. And this isn't really needed, but it is good because of the sun. Just like this, I don't really want to get more tanned on my arms or anywhere on my body, really. I'm pretty tan already. I think I can stay this tan, hopefully. But this is more of a summer thing, like I said. When the sun shines, I'll just put it on. So that way it kind of just protects my ears and my neck. But most of the time I'm wearing my helmet. So this, sometimes I don't even wear it because the time that I get there to grabbing the horse isn't that much. So it doesn't really matter as much. And then after my lesson, sometimes we'll stay there a little bit, but most of the time we'll be standing in the shade and it isn't that sunny now that it is fall. But in the summertime, I would take this a lot more just for safety if we stay there for a little longer after or get there really early before my lesson and need to do something at the barn without wearing my helmet. This is what the hat is for. Sometimes I'll like go without even wearing it because there's not much time where I'm not wearing my helmet. And speaking of helmet, I also take my helmet. It does need a little bit of a clean. I do have to admit there's a couple like scratches on it. But yeah, this is my helmet. It is a Troxel helmet. So I will wear my helmet from going to grab the horse to putting the horse back in its stall. So this is just for safety, for protection on my head, and I definitely have to make sure that I wear it when I go riding, just in case I fall off and I don't wanna injure my head. So I got a nice hard helmet. I think I hit it a little bit too much. It's pretty hard, yeah. So I have like a pile of all my stuff right here. Next is the last thing, and I'm wondering if you guys can guess it. It's something that the horses love. I'll give you a couple seconds to guess it. Okay, treats. It's treats. So I made my own horse cookie jar, and I actually bought my own horse cookies. I am going to be, once I run out of these, I'm going to be making my own. So keep an eye out for that video because that video is coming once I run out of horse treats. So if the horse is good, I will give the horse a couple treats, and then the barn also has their own treats. So I'll kind of give them an assortment of treats. And then also a couple hints on some of my next videos, maybe in the next couple of months. Because it is gonna take a little while because I got like a jumbo bag. They didn't have a smaller bag. They had like this jumbo bag of horse treats. I'm like, eh, okay, whatever, let's get them. And I have about a little less than half left. So I got some, I still have a good amount to go, but I am going to be making some horse treats and I am going to be turning that into a video. So it's gonna be like cooking my horse and I. So that is the first video hint. The second video hint is I am going to be making another horse cookie jar. It has gone dirty over the past couple of months that I've made it, just from taking it to the barn. It's gotten a little dirty, but it's okay. things get dirty with horses a lot. This got dirty with a bunch of horse hair. Everything gets dirty with horses. I'm just going to say that loud and clear. Everything gets dirty with horses. So I'm not really that bothered that it kind of got dirty so quickly, but I mean, it's okay. Anyway, back to the hint. So the hint is that I am going to be making another one of these. So it's going to be a DIY equestrian video, and I'm going to be doing a giveaway with it. So I'm not 100% sure how the giveaway is going to work just yet, but if you do want to take a chance at the giveaway, all you need to do is just let me know what color you might want the paint to be, just because that way I know, and then I'll kind of count up how many color, like which color has the most votes, I guess you could say. So what I'll do is I'll just kind of see what you guys say, what colors you guys say, and if a lot of people say the same color, then I'll just do the color that gets kind of the most people who want that color. I don't know any other way to say that. So yeah, I'm gonna be doing a giveaway with another one of these. So that is the two hints. Okay, so that is it for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you are new to the channel or you have not already done so, please like and subscribe, and I really do appreciate it. And I will see you next time.